which in the previous class we have completed our lesson and we have seen some of the vocabulary also. Yes. Now in this class we are going to learn some phasal verbs. Phasal verbs means what are phasal verbs? Phasal verbs means the word, whatever the sentence have given, and also what are the words are underlined in the given sentences, that should be identified. They are phasal verbs or not. Means whatever the word they have given, that should be known, should be known that into converted into own sentences also. And here they have given what are the phasal verbs also. Now I'm going to show how to identify the phasal verbs. Yes. Phasal verbs. Phasal verbs is a phase that has a verb in a combination with a preposition or an adverb or both. The meaning of phasal verbs is different from the meaning of its separate parts. Example, the PM called on the president at his residence yesterday. Now, here the phasal verbs can be identified. Means it is completely different from the own sentence. That how should be identified in the given sentence, that is a phasal verb. How? The preposition, the verb, adverb. The both preposition and adverb, the combination of preposition and adverb can be seen in the given sentence. How means the PM called on the president at his residence yesterday. Here the PM called on means on is an called and on is an adverb. At the same time prepositions are going to be used in the given sentences. Yes, that's why it is called a phasal verb. Yes, the meaning will be separate from the given parts, Nana. So everyone, if they give the sentence, we can underline the phasal verb. We can identify the phasal verb from that and we can underline. Or if they give the only the sentence, we can form a own sentence also. By taking the phasal verb from that, we can identify a phasal verb also. Okay? Now, here he is looking into the complaint. She is looking for a job. They looked at the beautiful painting. You can't bear to part with the painting. You have really caught him out, sir. Yes, these are the some of the verbs which can be seen in the textbook while the lessons also, while in the lesson also, like called on, looking for, and also looked at. And also part with. Caught. Yes, here the underlined verbs are said to be phasal verbs. These are the verbs can be used in the combination of preposition and also adverbs. Preposition and also adverbs in the following sentences. Here, the underlined parts in the above sentence are phasals. The phasal part means here showed that somebody did not show. No, but similarly the part means gives something to somebody else, especially something that would prefer to. Means they are preferring something. They are preferring something. We have to give the know that it is a phasal. Okay? Here, we have to consult a dictionary, that keep a dictionary and see the meaning of the phasal verbs. By that, we can easily form the own sentence also. Here, see everyone in the... Here now, phasal verb with catch, Nana. Catch on, catch into, catch out, catch upon, catch up with. These are the some of the phasal verbs. By you can see in the dictionary, using that word we get many of the words also. Yes, like catch on, become popular or fashionable. For example, by using become popular or fashionable, we can create a sentence. How? Guruvayya invited a new game, but it never really caught on. Yes, like this. We have to give the own sentences. Now,
Now you can collect some of the phrasal verbs by the foreign textbook, and you can keep the dictionary beside you, and you can write the meaning correctly. Okay, looking into means investigating, looking out for means notice someone or something, means something else. It is giving a identification there. Okay, get out of, avoid or escape, getting on with, managing, made up, compensated, look after, take care of, get through, succeed. These are the sentences by the above phrasal verbs, and by using this we can create a own sentence. Okay, now atoms. What is an atom? Yes, what is an atom? Atom. An atom is a phase similar to the phrasal verb. The meaning of atom is difficult to guess by looking an individual words. Nana, here atoms can be identified, cannot be identified in the textbook. Yes, cannot be identified in the textbook, but it can be make a own sentence, but which is similar. Phrasal and atom are similar, but here that can be seen in the dictionary with the many words. We can form with the many words. Here atoms are not like that. It is a phase, but similar to the phrasal verb only. But meaning of atom is difficult guessing, Nana. It is very difficult guessing to the form of individual. For example, B is the same boat in an item. B is the same boat has a literal meaning that it easy to understand, but it is also a common idiomatic meaning. It is also fair if doesn't make good is boost. Here makes good means carry out the promise. Means there will be different meaning to the given sentence. That is called an atom. Okay. Simply in we can say that Santa Vakyal. Okay, na. We should understand the given word. By that we have to create a new sentences to that. Okay. Make merry, make do, make it, make something of yourself, make like this. We can guess many many dictionary words out of this, and we can identify and we can make the own sentences by this. Okay. Once in a blue moon, bury the hatchet to make both ends meet, to burn the midnight oil. See, once in a blue moon is in a long interval. So we have to understand when they give the sentence or a word, first we have to understand that if you have get the meaning easily, we can make the own sentence easily. Not only a phrasal or a atoms, it is a similar to the same verb, but we have to know the meaning of the given words. Okay, so when they give the a long sentence, we have to understand the sentence first. Forgot the enmity, to make both ends meet, earn money for one's living, to burn the midnight oil, work or study until late night. Yes, these are the some of the examples for the atoms, which is going to post in the which I'm going to post in the group. Nana, you can understand easily. Okay. Now, short forms and long forms. We have already learnt in the 6th class what are the short forms and the long forms. Here I'm giving some of the examples and also full forms and by the short forms and full forms. Can't, will not, wouldn't. Wouldn't. Shall not. Must not. Mustn't. Must not. Hasn't. Isn't. Yes, these are the words which we are converting from full forms to short forms. If they give the short forms also, we can convert. If they say to write in full forms, we can use this. Okay, there are many words which are full form, which are in full form and short form. See, was not, wasn't, were not, weren't, are not, aren't, do not, don't, didn't, does not, doesn't, he will, he'll, she would, should, they had, that, she have, I have, Sita has, Sita's, Ravi is, Ravi's, like this, the different full forms can be converted into short form. When you are talking also with others, when you are, if they give the sentence and say to convert from short forms to long forms, where these are words are used, you can convert from the full forms to short forms, short forms to full form. Nana, don't be confused. Now, look at the following words they have given, some of the short forms, Nana, in the contracted forms, that if they have given a play here, and we have to convert into short forms and right forms. Here like this is type of drama act, and also it can be seen into conversation also. Here, I will give you. Here, they are saying to convert into short form. So, we have to write in a short form. I shall or will give you. Write in a full form. I didn't like you. I would like to see. I wouldn't to certain. I would not to be certain. Where has he? It is. Where he is he? Late. What is this? You are trying to. What is this? You are trying to. You can find some more in the play also. And you, from the textbook, you can take any para and you can do convert from the short forms and long forms. Okay? Read the conversation between Sarada and Usha and rewrite it in your notebook using the short forms whenever necessary. Here, we can understand easily that here some of the conversation was given between Sarada and Usha Nana. So, now we have to rewrite them. Same paragraph, same conversation, we have to convert in the form of by using short forms and long forms. By using short forms and long forms, we have to rewrite the given conversation. Okay, Sharada, what are you going to do after school? Usha, I will go home and take rest for an hour. See, let us see some of the given words. What are you going to do after school? Here they have given in the form of long form. Here in this paragraph, there are some in long form and in the some there are some short form also. Which are in short form, you have to change into long form. If which are in short forms, we have to change into long form. And which are in long form, we have to change in short forms. That is a different, that is a rewrite sentence, rewriting the conversation here. Okay? Now here, what are you going to do after school? I'm going to convert now this for short form. What are you going to do after school? Means like this, simply we are going to convert the paragraph into short form and long form. Okay? Now. Adverbs, manner. Look at the following sentences from the play you have read. The courtiers are waiting eagerly for Tenali to bring his paintings. Tenali look at the giggling. So here we have to angrily we are going to be save that. Something was eagerly playing to be act as a read here. So the following sentence should be changes into adverb. So that we have already learnt that eagerly,
angrily, and also some of the words which end with ly, which are ending with ly, that we are going to be seen and said to be adverb things. Yes. Now here they have given some of the, complete the following sentence with the following things. See here they have given some of the things we have to convert into adverb. By using the adverbs things, we are going to be converted into adverb things. Okay. Sriram speaks the English. He speaks dash. They have given some of the word in the bracket. Nana, correct. Correct, the word we have to use in the form of adverb by using the sentence. Sriram speaks correctly. The Sriram speaks the word correctly. Correct is an adjective. Correctly is an adverb. We have to mention whatever the parts of speech is going to be taken, and we have to write in the following line in the blank. Correct, correctly. Careless, carelessly. Yes. Loudly, quietly, carefully, correctly. Slowly, slowly, quietly, loudly. Yes. And also fast, good, well. It is a adjective and adverbs things we are going to see. Okay. Next, editing. Editing things. Here, in this passage, we have some of the errors. Nana. In this passage, we are having some of the errors. We have to correct. We have to. Yes. Here, the oldest fellow on my class was both Budraj, as all of us was afraid on him. He always had a catapult, excellent shooter. His favorite targets were birds. He would